In this video, I will talk about how to find the feasible regions of linear programming problems. The feasible region of a linear programming problem is a set of all points satisfying all the constraints and sign restrictions. For a linear constraint with two variables, we can show the feasible region graphically. For example, we have a constraint 2x1 plus x2 is less than or equal to 9. This constraint divides the two-dimensional space into two parts. One part is the feasible region, and the other part is the infeasible region. In order to find out which part is feasible, we change this inequality to an equation and draw this line in the two-dimensional space. We only need two points to draw this line. Let's set x1 to 0 and solve for x2. We find x2 is equal to 9. Then let's set x2 to 0 and solve for x1. We find x1 is equal to 4.5. This line passes through these two points. Now let's check which side is feasible. We can pick a point A, 0, 0. Let's plug it into the left-hand side. 2 times 0 plus 0 is equal to 0, which is less than or equal to 9. Therefore, point A is feasible. Then this entire side is feasible, and the other side is infeasible, because this is less than or equal to sine, so the line itself is in the feasible region. This is just one constraint. It will have more constraints. Then we need to find the intersection of all the feasible regions. Let's check this example. It has two constraints and two sine restrictions. Using the method introduced in the previous slide, we find that the feasible region of the sine restriction x1 is greater than or equal to 0 is from this line to the right. The feasible region of the sine restriction x2 is greater than or equal to 0 is above this line. The feasible region of the first constraint c1 is below this line. The feasible region of the second constraint c2 is below this line. The feasible region of the linear programming problem is the intersection of all these four feasible regions, which is the shaded area. In this example, the second constraint is changed to a greater than or equal to sign. So the feasible region of the second constraint C2 is above this line. And the feasible region of the linear programming problem is changed to this shaded area. In this example, the first constraint is also changed to a greater than or equal to sign. So the feasible region of the first constraint C1 is above this line. And the feasible region of the linear programming problem is changed to this shaded area. In this example, the first constraint is still less than or equal to, but the right-hand side is changed to 4. So the feasible region of the first constraint C1 is below this line. The second constraint is a greater than or equal to constraint, and the feasible region of the second constraint C2 is above this line. However, there is no intersection, and the feasible region of the problem is an empty set, so the problem is infeasible. Okay, that is how to find feasible regions of linear programming problems. Thanks for watching.